Everyone enjoying the conference? Great. I've decided that we're not going to hold conferences anymore. We're just going to have luncheons. Because I love it when you're all together in the room and the energy is here. It's great. I wanted to acknowledge the presence of Andrew Chen from Letitia James's office, the public advocate. Would you stand up and say hi to everybody? So it's great. We always get a lot of interest from the electeds about what we're doing here. At this time, this is not part of the program, but many of you know that about the recent passing of Don Nakanishi, and I wanted to introduce to you Rockwell Chin, who's going to speak a little bit about Don, having been a close friend of his, and because Don is such an important figure in the area of Asian American studies, it's important to hear about his life, his legacy, and that, of course, is all part of the work that we do, too, in trying to help carry on that legacy. Rocky and I taught a class together at Cornell, 1991, I think it was, on Asian Americans and the law. And I think we've been friends for at least 35 years. And I know that because of my daughter's age, I think, and when our families first met. So, Rocky, I'm going to turn the floor over to you. But I'm going to give you a minute first. Yes, thank you.
Well, thank you, Joyce, and I want to thank, excuse my voice. I came last week to the Leadership CUNY conference. Some of you were there, and this is a wonderful follow-up to that conference. I want to thank Joyce and the organizers, Russell Leung, for allowing me to say a few words about Don Nakanishi. And in thinking about it, I just wanted to say two prefatory remarks, actually, before I make this statement. About 8 or 9 years ago, in thinking about how I felt about Asian American studies and the importance of it, and I don't teach, I'm not in the academy anymore, we formed an organization of alumni. This question came up in the questions about the role of the alumni. And I think there are two aspects to it. One is I agree that the alumni should not be the only revenue source, because we deserve the institution to take a stand on the principle that Asian American studies is a legitimate area, however we define it, and this is a good discussion today. But the alumni is a powerful part of the university, much more powerful than we have tapped in the past. We have not done this. And I say this to encourage all of us to think about how we can do that. So we formed the Association of Asian American Yale Alumni. I only went to Yale for 2 years. My other connection is through my father, who graduated and got his PhD back in 1936, and he graduated in undergrad in 32, and my mother's father, who graduated from Yale in 1908. But I only was there for 2 years, and I don't normally do so-called bula-bula stuff, the reason I helped form AYA, or AYA, we call it, is because the alumni that come from this university, or Yale, or any of the other schools, are very privileged to go out in the world, and they, and all of you, our alumni of some school, have an opportunity to be change agents wherever you are. And one of the things I think we have to be united around is the challenge for our alumni now to become a powerful force to make Asian American studies ascend to its legitimate role in American society. No other time in history is this more important. For all the things we've talked about, I think we've left off the fact that the Asian American community needs Asian American studies. The government needs Asian American studies. So I'm just going to read the statement that the Association of Asian American Yale Alumni put out regarding Don Nakanishi, who would have been here. He sent me an email actually just a few days before, and he said, I'll see you in New York. So Don is here. Hopefully, maybe sometime in the future, we'll be able to do something larger for Don. This is coming out from the association. I helped work on it, but so many other people really wrote this. The Association of Asian American Yale Alumni mourns the loss of distinguished Yale alumnus Don Nakanishi, but finds inspiration in the extraordinary life he lived. An indefatigable and prolific scholar, his pioneering efforts and trailblazing methods established the bedrock upon which much of Asian American studies flourishes. A determined and fierce community advocate, his expansive and insightful exploration of Asian Pacific American Islander communities provoked a re-examination of commonly applied but ultimately mistaken assumptions and provided a framework for better understanding the actual roles and experiences of AAPIs, that's Asian American Pacific Islanders, particularly with respect to political participation and educational access and representation. An inspired teacher, devoted mentor, and loyal but never complacent Yalee, that's what Yalees call themselves, his steadfast commitment to access, diversity, and social justice left behind a profound legacy for Yale, for the AAPI community, and for people of color all over the country. Don, who passed away, by the way, just recently, his service, funeral service, was April 2nd. And Russell and I and a few other folks attended. A few other, probably a couple hundred. It was a packed Buddhist temple in Little Tokyo. Don was the son of parents who were born in the United States but who grew up in Hiroshima, got married, and later returned to the United States. His father worked as a supermarket produce clerk. His mother worked as a seamstress. During World War II, both his parents, along with more than 120,000 other Japanese Americans, were unjustly incarcerated by order of the U.S. government. Born and raised in East Los Angeles, Don grew up in the multi-ethnic working class neighborhood. Actually, it's predominantly Chicano neighborhood of East LA. He attended Roosevelt High School, that's Theodore Roosevelt, by the way, not the other one, where he served as student body president. As he recounted often there, he learned the important lessons that about building relationships and friendships across racial, ethnic, and class lines, lessons that would serve him well throughout his life. He received his BA, as we said, from Yale in 1971, his PhD also in political science from Harvard, 1978. Don's decision to attend Yale proved life-changing when he arrived in 1967. Approximately 1,000 men, by the way, Yale was all male at that time until his junior year, were in his class. 10 were black, 10 were Asian American, 1 was Pacific Islander, 3 were Puerto Rican, and none were Native American in the entire college. Even though Yale could not have been more different than Roosevelt High School, Don never regretted his decision. He loved the college, had many friends, enjoyed experiencing the East Coast, and had interesting professors and classes. In Don's words, every day seemed like a wonderful new adventure. Soon after arriving, Don had the first of several pivotal undergraduate experiences that would fuel and inspire a lifelong interest in Asian American studies and ethnic studies and in issues of social justice. Growing up, December 7th had always been a day Don dreaded. Whenever it arrived, he recalled there was always one teacher that would ask the class, "Do you know what happened on this day?" And students would raise their hands and a few would glance at the Japanese American students in the room. And a student would usually answer, "Oh, this was the day the Japanese bombed Pearl Harbor." As he stated years later, "I always felt uncomfortable, although I knew I did not have anything to do with it." During Don's freshman year on December 7th, it began as an uneventful day, but that evening it became vividly memorable. At 9 p.m., after settling into his room to study, everyone in his McClellan Hall dorm went to Don's room and began pelting him with water balloons, loudly chanting, "Bomb Pearl Harbor, bomb Pearl Harbor, bomb Pearl Harbor." A fellow student went up to Don and recited from memory President Franklin Delano Roosevelt's "This Day Will Live in Infamy" declaration of war speech. After his fellow classmates left, Don didn't know how to respond. As he later recalled, he didn't know whether to laugh or to cry. The incident weighed on Don. He did not seek guidance from his freshman counselor, college dean, or anyone else. He did not believe anyone would understand. Instead, he felt compelled to learn about what happened to his parents during the war. Like many Japanese Americans, his parents had remained cautious and stoically silent about their wartime internment experience. His schooling had taught him nothing about the forced incarceration. Don went to Sterling Library, checked out Prejudice, War, and Constitution, a book by three USC Berkeley law professors that provided a historical and legal analysis of the federal government's decision to imprison Japanese Americans. It was the first book Don had ever read about Japanese Americans on Asian Americans. From that beginning, Don developed several core beliefs that would guide his scholarship and teaching, his activities in the AAPI community, and his interactions with numerous other communities. He believed students want to learn about the historic and cultural experience of their own ethnic and racial groups. He believed that enhanced awareness of self and others was essential in addressing challenges of race in an increasingly diverse and interconnected society. He believed that teaching the Asian American experience was for the benefit of not just AAPIs, but for the benefit of society as a whole. Ultimately, what was the measure of the man? Not his accomplishments, though there were many, just to name a few, such as Amerasia Journal, which, by the way, this is the first copy of Amerasia Journal, which was at Yale, and then, of course, went to UCLA and continues to publish. Not the preeminent journal, also of Nexus, which he helped to start establish later. Not his awards and accolades, although there were continuing stream, such as the Yale Medal, the inaugural Engaged Scholar Award from the Association of Asian American Studies in 2009, and so forth. Not even his leadership in the community, where he was a recipient of many, many awards. Ultimately, the true measure of Don Nakanishi was found in something more essential: his enormous generosity of spirit, his determined and fierce advocacy, his inflammable commitment to broadening access and promoting diversity and ensuring social justice. These special gifts made Don a real champion of change that matters. His legacy will not be defined by things. Instead, it will be defined by the generation of students, colleagues, scholars, activists, and community leaders he mentored, counseled, and celebrated, and who now continue his work. In February 2015, during his keynote speech presented at the Yale Asian American Studies Conference, Don reflected on 45 years of Asian American Studies at Yale, and he told attendees that Asian American Studies had served a profoundly compelling and challenging professional and political focus in his life since his days at Yale as a Yale undergraduate. He noted that such a focus had resulted in a wonderful life journey, and it was a wonderful life journey indeed. So I think many of us don't choose where we live or the time we live in. I had the opportunity of knowing Don, being at the right place at the right time. And many of us should reflect upon the fact that he helped build the UCLA Asian American Studies Center, founded in 69 before he came, to now having over 40 tenure track faculty specialists in Asian American studies, offering over 70 undergraduate and graduate courses, which annually attract 3,000 students, publishes Amerasia Journal and AAPI Nexus and other books and publications. It's has the largest and most significant library and archival collections in the field, and maintains active partnerships with community-based organizations, civil rights groups, museums, libraries, and elected officials throughout California, across the nation, and other parts of the world. But Don also increased the endowment to the center to over $6 million through generous gifts and donations from alumni and friends worldwide, including six endowed academic chairs. I think we all need to congratulate Don for all he's done for Asian American Studies, but all of you here should understand you also have the power to be change agents, to work together. And I think that's something that Don would really love to see coming out of these conferences and what Ari is trying to do. Thank you very much.